Good evening, everyone. The time just hit 11 o'clock on your Sunday night. As we take a look, Waco, you guys are checking in at around 59 degrees. So pretty much everywhere across Central Texas are in those upper 50s to low 60s and a very light south-southeasterly breeze. Now, if we keep the breeze at around that pace, that's going to be good news, or higher than that. That would be good news in terms of not letting fog take over Central Texas as we head through the overnight hours, because we need the clear skies as well as calmer winds for fog to develop. We're pretty much in a mixed bag of low to mid 50s, even some upper 50s as well. Places like Cameron checking in at 58, same story for you guys down in Georgetown and Williamson County. A little cooler as you head to Killeen, Copperas Cove, Fort Hood, Hocker Heights, Nolanville. They're checking in at around 57. Now, we do have high pressure that's going to keep not only all of Texas dry, but pretty much the entirety of the southeastern and maybe even eastern third of the U.S. There is a system that's pushing off the Atlantic coast that brought us some of that rain earlier last week, but we do have another frontal boundary that's going to slide through later on Wednesday into Thursday morning that could bring us a few isolated showers or thunderstorms in terms of that. But we're going to be hovering around that 50-degree mark by the time we get to lows tonight. We're going to not get much cooler than where we are right now, folks, but there is a possibility of fog, especially in some of our southern and eastern zones, because those winds are going to start to slow down. I'm going to say between 3 and 8 miles an hour. And let's take a look at that future cast to see the timing of that fog, if it's all possible. At around 7 a.m., some areas might be within a half a mile, including Marlin and Temple, according to this model. Same story for Cameron, but a little bit less so in Waco. But if you do see any fog developing, you want to make sure you slow down, practice your social distancing between cars, and use low beam headlights, not high beams, because that can be dangerous for your eyes. It can shine a glare and can cause issues for you driving. So make sure you use those low beam headlights, and then that fog should start to mix out by the time we get to mid morning into late morning as well. But we could also see a mix of sun and clouds throughout the course of the afternoon. Now, as we go into Monday, low to mid 70s for high temperatures, partly cloudy skies, that southerly wind at around 5 to 15 miles an hour. And as a result of the morning fog, I'm going to give that an 8 on the Jordan meter, followed by that mix of sun and clouds. The clouds are going to be mainly of the high variety, so no real chances of precipitation, but those temperatures are going to start to move on up to those upper 70s before that frontal boundary moves through late Wednesday into Thursday. Friday, we could drop down to those mid 60s. It'll be a nice occasion when the Baylor Bears take down Oklahoma on Saturday. Sunny skies, temperatures around 67.